Hello and welcome to Uncommonly Good MTG. I am your host, Dr. Macho Man Randy SuckIt. That is a completely original name that has never been seen before in the history of the world. I am the first and only person, Dr. Macho Man Randy SuckIt. Anyway, so today I'm bringing to you a deck called Long Live the Deck. Long Live the Dead. So this, what the deal is that in a previous video, I went up against somebody that was playing Skeletal Swarming with a bunch of skeletons and Masked Vandal. And I said, oh, I have got to find that deck. You know, what's funny is I could not find it specifically. So I found another deck over on Aetherhub called Dank Dead, and it looked really, really close. So then I started changing out some of the things that I disagreed with the cards from that other deck I had seen, as well as sprinkling in a little Dr. SuckIt magic into it. So this is Long Live the Deck. I keep saying that. Long Live the Dead. Let's take a look what's in here. So at the early side of the game, we've got Bloodchief's Thirst, which destroys creatures and planeswalkers with mana value of 2 or less. So really, we're taking out creatures with this, and there's a ton that is going to be that way. Werewolves, some, you know, vampires, there's tons of stuff. All that spirit and white and green, red, just littered with it at the moment. So yeah, this is going to be a great card. And if we get backed into a corner, we got that, we got the ability to kick it to take care of anything. We got Persistent Specimen, who costs 1 to put out for a 1-1, and then he's a skeleton. So he's going to take all of the love from Skeletal Swarming. And then if he dies, you can return him from the graveyard to the battlefield tapped for 3. You know, so therefore, he's fantastic. He doesn't have to go back to your hand and then play him again. He just goes right back to the graveyard. I guess the big thing here is that, you know, he comes out tapped, which means if I had extra mana, I could potentially have a blocker quicker if I played one of that Sanitarium Skeleton. But I'm going to go for the low mana version here. We'll see how that works out. We got Shambling Ghast, who is she's sacrifice bait. You put her out, you sack her. You know, you use her to do a little bit of blocking, but once things get out of hand of her, you just pretty much toast her and take her abilities. You got that -1/-1 to somebody, or we got Created Treasure Token. She's good to be killed. Deadly Dispute will kill her, at which point you get 2 cards and a treasure, meaning if you take the Ghast treasure, you have 2 treasures and 2 cards out of that deal. For the same thing, we got Reckoner's Bargaining. In this case, instead of getting the treasure, we're getting 2 life, or life equal to the sacrificed permanent's mana value. So, you know, depending upon what you sacrifice, you could get a lot more. You know, it depends whether you want treasure or whether you want life. Other than that, you still are getting 2 cards out of the deal. So these are all good. And we're all trying to just trying to kill our little dudes to try to get up to Skeletal Swarming. And then that will start preparing little dudes that we could potentially kill if we need more, because essentially we need to get more. Like 2 Skeletal Swarmings is really nice. We have 4 in this deck, so hopefully we can dig for it. If they start killing it, hopefully we can dig for more. If we lose it, hopefully we won't just lose the game. There's still some stuff going on, but nothing super beefy here. Skeletal Swarming is what you have to keep things going. Masked Vandal, this is what I saw in that other deck. I thought this guy was great because he can, you know, being a changeling, he will count as a skeleton. And then also, you exile target artifact and enchantment and opponent controls as it comes into play, which is so important right now. Moss Pit Skeleton will either be 2-2 or 5-5, depending upon whether you play the kicker. And as you put other things out that have +1/+1 counters on it, then you will be able to bring this thing back to the top of your library and recast it. So we got a lot of recursion going on between this guy and the Persistent Specimen. We got Meathook Massacre, where number one, you can wipe a certain amount of the board. What's important is those other abilities there. Whenever a creature you control dies, your opponent loses 1 life, because your dudes are going to die, and a lot. But that's okay, because the hell will lose life too, and this is going to be good for that. And whenever a creature your opponent controls dies, you gain 1 life. So really, these are the effects that you're really looking for here. Death-Priest of Myrkul is a skeleton zombie lord who gives them +1/+1. And if something died, if a creature died this turn, you may pay 1. If you do, she will generate a skeleton token as well. So beautiful. Works totally well with this deck. It only has 2 right now. I mean, maybe 3 or 4 might be good. It just depends on how everything else goes. So I got a certain amount of removal in here. We got the Hagra Mauling, which the reason why this is in here specifically is because it can be a land. The land is only showing up at 21 cards right now. So this is the other two more lands, which pushes up to 23. So hopefully that'll be enough. If we start to choke a little bit more, we'll have to play around with the lands. We'll see how that goes. And Culling Ritual, which I'm convinced is one of the best new card, one of the best cards to be played right now, because it takes out creatures' permanents, non-land permanents, with a mana value of two or less. Like I said, that is the mana right now. That is the meta right now, is a bunch of cheap-ass creatures. No matter how strong they are, this will wipe them out. And it's destroy, which means that if you destroy your persistent specimen or your moss pit skeleton, you could just bring them back because these are going to the graveyard. We have the Skeletal Swarming, which says that each skeleton you control has trample, attacks each combat if able, and gets plus X plus O, where X is equal to the number of skeletons you control. So they become a trampling machine. And at the beginning of each end step, create a +1/+1 black skeleton token creature. If a creature dies this turn, create two of those instead. So this is the engine that just keeps going. And if they can't handle the enchantmentness of it, then they will be screwed if they can't finish you off soon enough. I put in four Hive of the Eye Tyrants. Originally, I had some Blood on the Snow in this deck, but I saw therefore we have the Snowlands. I'm leaving them in because you really can't be punished for Snowlands at this moment. And if I ever really wanted to put something back in that was snow related, then like Blizzard Brawl or something, then yeah, maybe we don't have to worry about the lands. So then we have some dual lands there. How many? I got four of them and two Field of Ruins. So ultimately, that is the deck. Let's see how well it does. And we're playing against EmeraldTaurus, which means Green Bull. All right, we got all green, and then nothing that can't be played unless we have at least black. Let's mulligan this thing. All right, we got a nice mix. We got a little bit of black, and we got some interesting stuff. Let's keep it. What are we worried about getting rid of here? Let's just get rid of that. All right, let's start it off with the Hive of the Eye Tyrant. Put out our skeleton. And we'll green up for this one. And we'll go in next. We can deadly dispute any time, so I will at least wait until his turn. My turn, huh? That is a lot of mana. All right, three. Destroy. Let's put out a persistent skeleton and autopay for it. We'll hold on to this for a little while. The Death Priest will be pretty good. We're playing against red and green. We got some Gruul action going on there. All right, yep, let's do this one. And no attacks, we're good to go. Another Death Priest and that skeleton suddenly be able to take out a mammoth. Not that mammoth. Do I care, do I care? Nope, it's too early to care. What do I need? Plenty of black. Let's play another green. Let's put another Death Priest out. I'm going to keep the skeleton back for blocking. Be nice if he doesn't put out another land, but there it is, and there's that. All right, this is exactly what I'm hoping not to go up against, because I do not have the ability to take out big mana creatures like that. What do I have the ability to put out though? I can take out the Goldspan Dragon, give him the additional mana that he needs. That's not good. Let's see. Let's all attack. Alright, there's 9. Yeah, we're dead. How did we just... What'd they just do? Yeah, that... I don't understand that one. Alright, playing against StJohnny. Let's see, we got... Let's keep it. We got plenty to do with the 2 black that we have. We can get out a treasure token, which will allow us to play a Masked Vandal, potentially. Something's telling me you gotta start sacrificing stuff. We're good to go. We'll hold on just a bit. You know, he's only got 19 more turns until he's dead, so I think we'll be okay. That was sarcasm, by the way. Yeah, it's kind of disappointing not getting any sort of mana. That's not really going to do it. All right, we're going for the attack, and he's not going to buy it. Let us try to go for a Deadly Dispute. We'll cast it on a Ghast. We'll take a treasure token for it. How interesting. We'll cast another Ghast. We'll cast another Ghast. No. Let's Masked Vandal this thing. Auto pay. Do I have anything in here? Yeah, we do. Get rid of that, kill that, we're good to go. That's what Masked Vandal's for. So it looks like we got somebody who's playing legendaries. Okay, let's go to town. And they got another one. Okay, well, there's some green mana. And we need, what, 5 for that? So let's not do that at the moment. We will put out our friend right here. And, let's go in for the attack. I think he's got another Magda in his hand. I could really use that meat hook. Kick. No attacks. Let's see, what do we got? Two, three. That's definitely wipe some stuff out there. Let's go looking for some things, though. Wow, that is a whole lot of nothing good, isn't it? So I can wipe out what is this guy? This guy's a two as well. Nah, I'll keep that for the moment. Do I need another blocker? Yeah, let's block. Auto pay. So I've got, what, 5 mana right there? That's enough to keep things going. No attacks. Jeez. Because these are all outside of my range to kill is the problem. Everything I have is going to die, so I might as well just throw it out there as a blocker. There we go. Man land. Sure, that's fine. So I've got 4, which means I can put out. I got 5 total. What can I do? I could do this. And then sacrifice it to go look for something good. Let's do that. All right, not bad. Still, I mean, I can only kill one of them. Well, it's kind of weird the cards are being shuffled, really. Yeah, see, they got 10. Needle. Something a little more persistent. Okay, artifact enchantment, that looks good. Yep, and let's get rid of this chick. Oh no, I'm surprised that those things are still living. There we go. Pop that out, and what does this thing do? Whenever a modified creature have trample. All right, there we go. That trample is going to suck. What do we got here? Nothing in the spirit, and that's it, huh? Now, these are the 2. Take action, yep. Because that's just a guarantee. Nothing to kill with the other guy, so we will... he'll get totally buff and just come through. Yeah, we're on the losing side of this. And let's just let it go. No choice. Yeah, okay. I guess we should have known that was coming. Game over, man. Game over. All right, going up against Daifeeloo. And we got a nice mix. We got a Meathook Massacre. Let's keep it. See how things go with this. All right, let's play it out as a black. We'll throw out the Ghast. We could potentially Deadly Dispute. We'll throw out the green. Wait, onto their turn. There we go, we're getting someplace good. So let's see, I'll put out another black, which is important. So we're up to five right now. Let's do it. Go ahead and put out the swarming. Auto pay it. All right, they need to be able to handle the enchantment with black. What does this guy do? Death touch. Yeah, whatever. Let's see. So do I have any mana? I do not. I got three to play with. Let's just go ahead and kill this guy. Is he cost too much? What does he cost? Three. Okay. Let's go ahead and put out a Skeletal Swarming. And let's put out a 2-point Skeleton. And then we have to attack. Yes, we're doing pretty good on our load. We'll go ahead and wipe out the Death Toucher. Because he wanted to put out another one, apparently. All right, now we could just kill it. And lay down the boom. All right, so we got a Bloodchief first for whoever comes out next. And then we'll just lay it all out. No matter what, we've got, what is this, 21 points of trample? Or it was more than that. Well, there, game's over. Good game. All right, that's how this deck is supposed to go. Okay, so this is Long Live the Dead. And you can see that it could do very, very well. That last game, you know, with the way that the treasures lined up, the fact that we had Skeletal Swarming in our first hand, you know, you ramp up quick enough and you get a Skeletal Swarming out early. They really can't handle it. Now, if you got those decks that are playing anti-enchantment, they can handle it. But if they're not, or they haven't gotten to it, then they got a big problem on their hand, because Skeletal Swarming gets out of hand quickly if it isn't taken care of. So, you know, Skeletal Swarming is your MVP. You need to get to it. The way you get to it is by way of your Deadly Disputes and your Reckoner's Bargain, which allows you to draw two additional cards per turn. You should be able to get to one fairly early because of it. In, like, what was the second game we played? No matter what we did, they were, like, shuffled all to the bottom or something. I don't know what happened. We could not find them ever. Masked Vandal, I'm sure you saw it. This guy was beautiful. He comes out, you sacrifice some jerkwad you have in your graveyard, and he exiles an artifact or enchantment. And right now, that is so important. So yeah, this guy is fantastic and should totally be in here and is working. The Moss Pit Skeleton, fantastic as far as his recursion ability, and the fact that he can be a 5/5 if you got the mana for it, so good. Meathook Massacre. I'm not sure we used it in any of the three decks that we have, but it, I can tell you this, if you get it out, even if you pay it for zero, it's still going to have, it's going to be an investment that's going to pay dividends. Persistent Specimen. I'm beginning to think that that other, the Sanitarium one, is probably a better guy. I think if I remember right, he's actually a 2/1. And what is good about him is even though he costs more because he has to go back from the graveyard to your hand, but then pay one to put him out potentially, but at least he is been untapped and can block, while Persistent Specimen isn't. Now, on the other fact, one thing, the trick we did play is that I just took him from the graveyard, put him into the battlefield for 3, and then used that extra one to play Deadly Dispute or Reckoner's Bargain, whichever of those two. So therefore, it only cost me 4 rather than the 5 it would have costed to be able to just throw a dude out and draw 2 cards and get some extra stuff. So it just depends. I'm beginning to think that the ability to defend potentially is worth that extra mana. Death-Priest of Myrkul was good. I thought that the lording up was fantastic. I wish that she could have stayed out for longer. She's not one of the things that she lords, but still, I think that she has a strong place in this deck. So there were times where this deck seemed to just sort of like just roll around in the low end too much, and maybe that is a problem, but it's all about sacking those guys to get new cards to find your Skeletal Swarming. So I don't know, if you think you can tune this deck to be a little bit tighter, go for it, but I thought this was a lot of fun, especially in that last game. So what would I rate this thing? I'm giving it a B plus right now. That'd be my rating. And we'll see what it does if we get around to playing it again in the future. That's it for now. If you like this video, please make sure to like and subscribe. From all of us here in the secret underground headquarters of Uncommonly Good MTG, have a great day. See you next time. Later.